Little was known about the new chimera conversion process outside of Dr. Claude Bouchard's research. We knew that until recently, no female chimera had ever been seen. Human females, it seemed, had been stored in the catacombs' DNA facility for use in later phases of the chimera invasion. Bouchard wrote that inside the chrysalis lair was a structure she called le cœur de la mère, the mother chamber. It was here that the chimera DNA was implanted into human subjects before they were taken to facilities like the one in Bonn. To deploy the serum and infect the carriers, Grayson would have to enter this heart, the womb where the chimera hags were conceived in the bodies of human females. Colonel Roland Mallory disappeared in Paris and has to this day never been seen again. Later, Marquis Command questioned Grayson, but Grayson had nothing to say and the case was never remanded to military authority. Once, I had also asked Grayson what transpired inside the chrysalis lair, and all he would ever say was that everything changed.
Parker, I'm inside the lair. It's like no conversion complex I've ever seen.
Grayson, I can't read you. Come in. Grayson!
Oh, I don't even want to know what this shit is. Door.
I'm nearing the upper levels of the lair. Carriers moving in and out, like blood vessels carrying oxygen. This is what Rain discovered. It's like a bloody Chimera assembly line. The carriers retrieve the bodies from storage, like the chamber beneath Paris, and bring them here, where the transformation process begins. And where it's going to end. Never doing that again.
Fucking hell!
Thank you.
mean.
Going to inject the serum. Whoa! What just...
Parker, I was trapped underwater. I should have drowned, but I can breathe this fluid.
To deploy the serum and infect the carriers, Grayson would have to enter this heart, the womb where the Chimera hags were conceived in the bodies of human females.
To help me, James.
Get out of my head!
You think you can resist, but you are mistaken. Join us.
The way my brother joined you? It's too late, Rain. The serum's already spreading. Like a virus. The entire system's collapsing. How many carriers have already left infected, Rain? How long before this is all gone?
Against me.
Then I'll keep trying until I find one that works.
Kill you, Rain. You know that.
Not me. I am on your side.
I should have killed you when I had the chance.
I see you staring. Don't be shy. I am beautiful now.
You weren't so shabby before. Still alive. This would blow his mind. You when I had the chance.
You can't kill us. You are sinking well into your resources. Now wounds us. Infinity number. We will not stop.
You're wrong, Rain. Or whatever the hell you are. The serum is working. Your father's virus is spreading. Soon, every carrier in the world will be dead.
James! We're not dead. The serum spread. Set off triggers. They're so advanced.
Rain, what are you saying?
Carrier's gone. Just triggered new types. Spinners. James, no matter what we do, they just keep evolving.
Rain! Goodbye, Ray.
Cartwright's task force was successful. Just as in London, when the Paris Tower fell, Chimera forces everywhere in Western Europe became disorganized, confused, and began to die. Grayson was also successful. At least it seemed so at first. Dr. Bouchard's serum worked as designed. Carriers spread the contaminated fluid from the mother chamber to facilities all over France and Germany. The new conversion process ground to a halt. But while Western Europe had earned a short reprieve, reports continued to come in from Russia, the Balkans, and Spain. Chimera forces were on the move. Vast fleets of Chimera dropships were being constructed, their targets and destinations unknown. Grayson never talked about what happened inside the Chrysalis lair to anyone, but it was obvious to everyone that Grayson was changed in ways we would never understand. Did you ever find any sign of her? Bouchard, I mean.
Yeah. I found her. She was already dead.
I don't know what happened in there, James, but don't let her death destroy you the way you let your brother's. It's time to bury our dead.
I don't need a lecture, Parker. I'll be fine.
Wait. I've got something for you. British Command has cleared your record. We're offering you a field commission. How does Major Grayson sound?
Well, sitting my arse all day like Cartwright. Hey, speak of the devil.
Grayson, I've been looking for you. I think this is yours. Some of the boys found it during mop-up. I thought you'd want it.
It belongs here. As someone said, it's time to bury our dead.
Keep it, James. Your brother would want you to.
Maybe he would have at that. Goodbye, Colonel. Major.
Goodbye, James.
Hey, I hear the McKee have a replacement opening for a colonel. Maybe I'll apply.
Goodbye, James.
Shall we? There's still a war going on, last I checked.
We never saw Grayson again. He did join the Marquis, volunteering to lead a dangerous mission into the heart of Russia to find the source of the Chimera invasion. During the Battle of Warsaw, 12th of June 1953, the Marquis listed Grayson as missing in action. But I had to wonder. Among the Russian refugees, there were rumors of a British soldier seen roaming the streets of Minsk, Kiev, and Moscow. A man they called the Cloven Killer. Perhaps Grayson did die in Warsaw. But I like to think that somewhere out there, James Grayson had found another cause worth living for.